Hello guys, Sanjay here, and in this video I'm going to show you guys how to install Windows 10 on your laptop with DOS operating system. Having DOS operating system is like having nothing, and to do this you will need a ISO file, and you can download the ISO file from the link which will be given in the description box too. And if you want to install the 32-bit version on your laptop, then select 32-bit version, or if you want to select 64-bit version, then select that also. And you will need a pen drive also with minimum space of 8 GB, which must be at your home, so do not worry about that. And once you download that program, it's almost around 19 to 20 MB. So once you download that, we need to create an installation media for another PC, that is our laptop. So select the second option. Now hit next. And now select your preferred language. For me it's English, so I'm selecting English United States, and I want to install Windows 10 Pro. But if you want to install something else, then you can select that from here also with no issues. And x86 means 32-bit and x64 means 64-bit, so that's quite obvious. And as we want to download the ISO file and we do not want to install it in the USB flash drive, select the second option, that is ISO file, and then select next. So by this the ISO file will be downloaded, and you need to select the location where you want to download. I want to download it on desktop only, so I'll select desktop and just hit next, and the download will start, and my video is also getting uploaded, so that's a good thing. And till the time the ISO file is getting downloaded, let's download Rufus, which will be required to flash the ISO file on the pen drive. I'll give the download link of this application also in the description box below, so do not worry about that. And once the application is downloaded, it will not take that much time for you. My internet is only 1 Mbps, so that's why it's taking such a long time, so I just skipped it. Anyways, once you open the application, attach your pen drive to your PC and it will detect the pen drive automatically. And make sure that you have selected your pen drive only and not a hard disk. So if you select your hard drive, then the complete hard drive will be wiped, so take care about that. And after this we need to select the ISO file. So I have kept the ISO file in some different locations, so I redirected it to that folder and selected the ISO file. And for you it might be on desktop, so you will have to select desktop. And once you hit the start option, you will see something as all the data on the pen drive will be wiped. So yeah, if you have any important data which will save your life, then do backup that data to your PC, because complete data on the pen drive will be wiped. And once the ISO flashing is done, we need to put the pen drive on your laptop. So just open up your laptop and attach your pen drive to any of the USB ports. I'll prefer USB 3.0 port because that's the fastest one. And now simply start your laptop. And this is where the tricky part comes in. You need to get into the BIOS menu. And this procedure is completely different for all the laptops. So I had to try different things, like I had to press escape, then F9, then different things like that on this HP laptop. But for a Dell laptop or for for a Dell laptop or Lenovo laptop, it might be different. So keep pressing F9, F10 or delete or escape key. These are the keys which will most probably have your BIOS setup. But on my HP laptop, I had to press escape key. And then it showed me these menus, so I want to change the boot device options, that is the F9 option. So to change that, obviously I'll have to press F9, so press F9 over here. And these are the options that I have. So I want to boot from USB hard drive, that is Jet Flash Transcend 8 GB. So select the third option over here. It might look a little different on your BIOS menu, that varies from BIOS menu to BIOS menu, but make sure to select USB hard drive. And from here, once again select the language that you want to install. I'll just use the English United States. Hit next and select install now, because we want to install the Windows 10 right now, so select install now. And it will ask you for a key, but as of now we do not have any type of key, so we'll just skip this part as of now. So hit the skip over here, just smash it with your mouse. Yeah, smash it. Yeah, it will take a little bit of time. Yeah, and select I accept the license terms. These are quite normal things to do. Hit next. And we want to install new version of Windows, like we do not want to upgrade our Windows 7, or we cannot upgrade our DOS to Windows 10 with the first option. So select second option, that is custom install Windows. And now you will see three options, and we want to install it in the third hard disk, that is of 915.9 GB, that's almost 1 TB. But before you install, make sure that you hit on new and select apply. And do not even try to install Windows 10 on the other two partitions. It won't take place because the space is like very low. simply select the third partition and hit next to install Windows 10. And as it is primary, yeah, we can install Windows 10 on that. And the copying of Windows files has started now. So this complete procedure might take around 15 to 20 minutes depending on your PC specs or laptop specs. So yeah, just wait and watch the screen of your laptop while it gets completed. So almost everything is done and the green bar over here is running towards the end, and that's a great thing. And yeah, come on guys, come on laptop, come on, yeah. Now it's saying restarting in 9 seconds, 8 seconds, blah, 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 blah. So it will restart automatically now. And yeah, I just fast forwarded it. And that there is my friend once again. And after that is done, you can remove your pen drive safely and the Windows 10 installation will go on without pen drive now. And once you install the Windows 10, and this is the first time that we have installed, so the resolution will be different. So go into option, then go into display settings and change the resolution to a different thing. So for my laptop, it's 1366 into 768, hit apply and select keep changes. Now the display will look very much familiar. And from here, you need to install the drivers for your laptop, and the drivers for your laptop will be available on your laptop manufacturer's site. So go visit that site and download all the drivers and install all the drivers. Yeah, all the drivers. So yeah, this is it for this video guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more tricks like this. And if you still have any doubts, suggestions or queries regarding this video, then do let me know about that in the comment section below. I'll surely try to answer your queries. And yeah, don't forget to hit the like button if you install Windows 10 on your DOS enabled laptop. So yeah, this is it for this video guys. Thank you for watching.